is like so much easier with him because we also don't speak in English to each other, so no one understands, and we don't really fight of communication or miss something. Like if someone misses it, it's okay.
It just helped build a better relationship with your sibling through sports, with all the ups and downs it is.
I would agree, and I think during high school when we were both getting recruited, you know, it wasn't a make or break situation where we had to go to the same school, but we always thought it would be awesome, it'd be pretty cool if we both got the same scholarship offer and we could both attend the same university, and thankful for the University of Delaware, and it worked out like that, so it's been pretty awesome.
It's really cool. You know, I've been playing with him since I was a little kid all the way through high school, and now, I don't know, it's just kind of a blessing to be with him every day.
I think it's pretty cool. I mean, I was kind of obviously part of his recruiting process. He's been playing in the backyard forever, so it's pretty fun, very cool.
It's awesome, like, just being out there with him. We have a lot of great chemistry, the way we grew up together, training together, doing everything together, and being out on the field. We have that good communication, good chemistry. We know what each other's thinking, and it's really fun to celebrate with him too.
Steven, by 1 million. He always had to get up first when we were growing up. We shared a bathroom, so he would probably take half hour to tie his shoes in the morning. He doesn't wake up until like 9 a.m. at the absolute earliest.
I think it's a combination. I think he's a slow worker, and he's got to maintain a little bit of that afro he's got going on there.
Yeah.
He's got a system.
I do too.
He does. Yeah.
Yeah.
He has
maybe
to try on like 5 things before he
maybe it comes with the
chooses.
Messy part.
I was sending you some videos about too.
Oh, the strong man.
I showed him a strong man video of like these guys who pretended and got on the morning show in Wisconsin, and they were just doing like dumb stuff, just like lifting like milk jugs. And then I also sent him the kid who yodeled, but then I sent him the EDM version.
The dubstep version of the yodel kid.
Yeah.
Well, how are you getting down here probably?
Yeah.
He said we have this at 1.
I said, video at 1.
I said, that's today. He said, yeah, lol. Ugh, ha ha ha.
I'm trying to think of like a fancy one for you.
You'd probably be a Philly cheesesteak.
Going off that, you're probably a salmon meal.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
I can think of a pizza, but not a pizza.
Okay, or another
pizza. I'm meat lover.
Why is that?
Meat. A lot of meat.
Kobe would be a chicken tender because for the first 20 years of his life, that's pretty much all he ate everywhere.
Can't think of anything specific, but I'm gonna go with venison because we had this childhood joke that Troy's eyes were wide. It was like on the side of his head, like looking out like this. It's like, so he's a deer, maybe jerky him up and yeah, that's venison for you.
All right, huh? Yes, I guess I'm venison.